In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create the facade for this really cool, interesting building, and it's going to be simpler and easier than you might think. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Also there you can find some really high quality Revit templates, families, and plugins. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. We have this created kind of as a starting point. You can see in the 3D, we have some walls, basically a circular wall, and some of these kind of star-ish floors. And now it's time to do the facade. So let's go down here into level three. We're simply starting from level three because the bottom two floors are a little bit different. So then let's go to level three. And here I have sketched out basically the shape of this facade wall. So what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to component, model in place, and then let's search for, let's do this as walls, click OK. And then click OK again. And now I'm simply going to be using an extrusion. And then here in the draw tools, I'm going to use pick lines. And then let's pick this line, this line, this line, this one, and these two. Okay, so once these have been selected, I can just hit finish. Let's go to the south elevation. Here we can see that extrusion. I'm just going to extrude it up a little bit and then also down. And now, just to make it a little bit simpler, let's go here to create, add a reference plane. RP is the shortcut, and I'm just going to place one here on top and then one here on the bottom. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Then let's select the top one. So from the level, go up 500 millimeters. And then here from the level, go down also 500 millimeters. Okay, so once we have these in place, then we can just adjust our wall to that. Now let's go back into our level three. Here we have that facade wall. Now let's go back to create and let's create a void form, a void extrusion. So I'm just going to be using pick lines again, and then I'm going to pick this line, this line, this line, and this line. And then I'm going to give it an offset of 500 millimeters, hit enter. And then let's come, make sure to come from this side. If you come from the other one, it's going to go to the outside. You want to go to the inside like this, and then like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times and then switch to trim and extend to corner. Here, you want to be careful. You first want to pick this line and then the inner one, and then fix it up on the outside. Repeat the same process here, just like that, and then hit finish. Now let's go to the 3D view, or sorry, south elevation, and then here let's extend it up just like that. And now what we can do is we can go to cut geometry, or oh, it looks like it cut it already. If I go to the 3D view, yeah, there we go, looks perfect. No need for cut geometry. Then let's hit the escape key a couple of times, and we have our main shape. Now let's hit finish model. The next step is going to be to basically array this all the way around our building. So for that, let's go back into level three. Let's select this and then let's go to array. Here you want to make sure it's a radial array, and then you want to make sure that the number is 24 because we want to have 24 of these, and you want to check move to second. You want to place the center of rotation in the actual center of the building. And then I'm just going to go from this point up to this point. And as you can see, it had arrayed basically this all the way around. Now hit the escape key a couple of times. Let's select one of these items. Now this has been grouped, that's okay. You want to go here into edit group. You want to select that item. You want to go to copy to clipboard. And now we want to paste that on the next level, which will be level four. And then when you click OK, as you can see, it has been copied up here. Now you just want to go to remove, click on that, remove it from that group, hit finish. And now we have this second element. So now let's switch to level four, find here level four. There we go. I can zoom in here, and then we want to move this. So let's go to rotate, And then let's place the center of rotation in the actual center. And then I'm just going to move it from here up to here, just like that. And then hit the escape key a couple of times. And now let's go to the 3D view just to see what that looks like. And it seems to be intertwining with the bottom walls perfectly. So let's select that, go back into level 4, and now let's copy it around by using the array tool. Again, go with the same radial array, 24 items, move to second, place the center of rotation in the actual center, and then let's move it from here to here. And now it's ready. So it has been copied. Let's check it in the 3D view. Yeah, looks perfect. So now we can just hit the escape key a couple of times and there we go. Now it's time for the railing. So what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to level 4. I'm going to find this wall that's actually in level 4. So we're not working on that one. We're going to be working on the one below. So here, let's then go to architecture, find railing, click on railing. I'm going to be using this Balkan Architect railing, which I have prepared. And then let's use pick lines for offset, and let's give it an offset of 75 millimeters. Hit enter, and then here I'm just going to place that railing just like that. Then let's hit finish, go to the 3D view, and this is what that railing looks like. Now what I'll do is I'm just going to select this group, go into edit group, go to add, and then I'm just going to add this railing to that group, hit finish, and then it's basically going to copy that all the way around. So we have railing within this group. Now let's repeat the same thing for level 5. So find level 5, there we go. Again, let's go to railing and use pick lines, give it an offset of 75, just so you can find the center, and then just place that railing. Go back to 3D view, make sure that the base offset is 500, hit finish, perfect. And now let's add this to the group as well. So select this group, go into edit group, go to add, and then let's add that railing, and then hit finish. There we go. So now we have everything pretty much set up. So we have all of the railing and all of the elements. Now it's just a matter of arraying this all the way up the building. So let's go to the south elevation for that. Then I'm going to zoom in, make a broad selection of these two floors, just like that, or these two levels, go to filter, use check none, and then just check model groups, hit apply. Okay, so we have only the groups selected, and then I'm just going to array these. So for the rest of these floors, we need 7. So let's make sure you set this to linear array. For the number, set that to 7. And then let's go to move to second. So let's go from here to here, just like that. And then let's wait for Revit to do its magic. And it's done. So I'm going to go to the 3D view just to see what that looks like. Okay. Perfect. So we have this really impressive facade, this kind of woven facade created in Revit. And as you can see, the process really isn't that difficult or complex. You just need to kind of figure out the way to approach it. Once you have that, it's actually really simple to complete this facade. Now, if you want to get access to this Revit project file, both the start file and the finished model, you can find that with all of my other Revit project files, over 500 files so far, on my Patreon page. I'm going to link that up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.